We weren't winning by 8 or 10 or 12. We were winning by 20.
You could see the whole LeBron phenomena and then the team phenomena grow and grow and grow.
You know, when you're winning, you don't see as much as you would see if you were losing. We're playing these highly ranked teams in the country, and we're winning 100 to 50.
And the Irish blew away the Bulldogs 76-36.
80 to 35.
St. Vincent St. Mary's dominates again, 78-49.
I kept hearing about this player, Carmelo Anthony, and I'm like, whatever.
Country, stateside, city side, it was bananas. It was like, we felt invincible. It was like, untouchables.
Travis from LeBron James. Travis from James.
After a while, you started saying, wow, is this one of the greatest teams in high school basketball history?
First time I saw LeBron play was in Akron. And I think that the tendency, especially when you're a skeptical sports writer, is to try and nitpick and say to yourself, this kid isn't as good as everyone says he is. And yet, he was that good. And so I pitched the story to Sports Illustrated.
Been dubbed the chosen one, according to Sports Illustrated. LeBron is the first high school athlete to grace the magazine's cover in 36 years.
Nobody from Akron had ever been on the cover of Sports Illustrated before. You've got kids from Texas and New York City reading about this kid from Akron, Ohio.
The Ohio National and world media have been following the St. Vincent St. Mary star all season long, searching.
Once the Sports Illustrated thing goes on, everything was just amplified. People sing around, now people gather around, now people jump around. Today's ESPN internet generation, what happens in one small corner of the country or the world can be worldwide. These kids were right at the forefront of it, so when they went someplace, people knew them by name.
LeBron James has his own t-shirt that you can buy here at the game.
LeBron James, and a 30-point win sends the Irish to the regional semifinals.
LeBron!
As a journalist, you do think about what it's going to do to somebody's life when someone that young, who hasn't really done anything yet, is put on the cover of the magazine.
And how do you tell 16, 17-year-old kids, don't let it get you ahead, but there's about 300 kids out there waiting for autographs. Go, go,
go, go, go, go. We definitely had a swagger about us, and we had a strong swagger. It's your birthday, we gon' sip a card and like it's your birthday.
And you know we don't give up, cause that's your birthday, you'll find me in the club. Can you talk about your relationship with LeBron James?
Yeah, I've seen him play, he's very talented. Six ain't into making love, so come give me a hug. If you're getting rough, you'll
find me in the club. Bottle full of blood, mama, I got what you need. Ultimately, what it comes down to is the belief in yourself. And if he has that, he'll be fine.
You probably could do some damage on the next level time.
Damn, took off from the Atlantic.
One more time. Coach Snow, one more time. One more time.
You get that invincibility trait where you think that, hey, it doesn't matter. I can turn it on and off whenever I want.
When you've coached a group of guys from the time they were 10, sometimes, you know, you get to a point where they stop listening to you. They stop hearing you.
How is that not a part of the play?
No. Gio was right here. The ball was here. And we're going to spread the play. Go.
Even if you don't, you still set it up.
I could see some problems coming that could lead to disaster, and I didn't think there was anything Coach Drew could do about it.
We were winning and we were young, so, you know, we blew them off like, whatever. We're going to win anyway. My flow, my show brought me to
go. That brought me all my fancy things. Partying late at night, you know what I'm saying, having people come visit at the hotel.
You know, we got a game the next day, but who cares? We still winning by 40.
Now, We're on a national scale, and I don't want any mistakes. If Drew had a turnover, it was like he had 10 turnovers. We bumped heads because, you know, now I'm requiring perfection from him and maybe not from everyone else.
If you can't let it go, then, you know, then let me know, and then I'm not going to play.
She told you I don't have an attitude. Why don't you listen?
Really?
Point guard, leader.
The only team that's going to beat St. Vincent, St. Mary's is us. And these kind of attitudes is what's going to beat us.
We need to defend the state champion, you know? They got to come beat us. I'm not being cocky, but that's that. Just how player I am. I'm guaranteeing I'm not going to let my team lose. I don't want my team losing, and I know they don't want to lose. And I ain't going to let it happen.
A sellout crowd awaits us here at the Value City Arena. Akron, St. Vincent, St. Mary will throw their high-powered offense up against a team that fully expected to be playing in this game today.
You guys are not ready to play. You're underestimating these guys. You guys think you can turn it on and off like the faucet, but you can't. If you think this team is going to walk out there and let you walk away with this, you're fooling yourselves, right, fellas? You're fooling yourselves.
A new head coach, Drew Joyce, really stepped into a pressure cooker job.
It's going to be a tough road for St. Vincent.
Complacent, arrogant, selfishness. That's not what we're about.
They believe in their style of play.
We're not backing down from these guys. We're not changing a thing. We're going right at them.
That's why I like this matchup today.
The opening tip, the Division II state championship game, and the opening tackle is controlled by Akron, St. Vincent, St. Mary.
We played them earlier that year at Kent State. Blew them out. You know, we thinking, hey, can't beat us.
James working on Wyrick, spins to the baseline, leaves it inside for Travis.
I tell you, this young man can pass the finish.
Early on, Roger Bacon, they made it very clear they were a very good team, that it wasn't going to be easy.
The other way come the Spartans from Roger Bacon, and it's Beckham Wyrick with his team back ahead by a point. We go up and down the floor here in the first quarter.
We struggled early. LeBron couldn't do some of the things they had done so easily.
Big play here this morning in Columbus. The media crush and the fourth personal foul on LeBron James as he spins into the lane and a charge is called.
It's just like everything happened wrong at the right time.
In this third quarter with no points.
The lob to Beckham Wyrick. Able to answer the drive by James. 7 minutes and 10 seconds remain in the Division II state championship game here at the Value City Arena in Columbus. Offensive rebounding, a big factor in this one. That's been one of the reasons that Roger Bacon has been able to stay in. James can't finish inside. Took the lob from Drew Joyce and can't finish. And it's a 5-on-4 game right now. James a little slow getting back down the floor.
And that's what's hurting him. That's what's hurting him.
St. Clair on the baseline scores.
You cannot sit back and watch.
We just started unraveling.
Phillips on the baseline now. Wyrick had a block from behind. And if that's on Romeo Travis, he's just fouled out of the game. Travis beside himself. And Travis has fouled out of the game.
We're in the backseat right now. We got to do something.
Under a minute and a half to go. LeBron James glides to the baseline. And goes here. Finishes with a big-time flourish.
That was definitely big time there.
Working on Wyrick into the lane. They kick it back to Drew Joyce. Had it knocked away from the line. Roger Bacon with his ball. It's Frank Phillips on the shoulders to the glass. The lead stands at 3 with 22 seconds left. 66-63. Cincinnati, Roger Bacon, Akron, St. Vincent, St. Mary's, the basketball. With 17 seconds left in the game. Score and time. Lower right of your screen. Mraz curls off a pick for the tie. No good. Hot foul. Rebound. With 9 seconds left for the foul. St. Vincent, St. Mary's, Drew Joyce, the player Drew Joyce, who disgustedly fires the basketball at the basket after the foul was called. And Drew Joyce has just been hit with a technical foul. The key to this is now, after the free throw.
All intents and purposes, that put the nail in the coffin, I think, for St. Pete.
St. Vincent, St. Mary, and won the Division II state championship. The first loss to a team from the state of Ohio since the 1998-99 season.